Everybody in between, to Ranger Hockey right here on Lakes Area Community Television. It is a Tuesday, January 3rd, 2017. Welcome to the new year of Ranger Hockey. Forest Lake hosting the 4-3 Stillwater Ponies here tonight. This is game 13 of a 25-game season for your Rangers. Game one of a two-game series between these two teams. They will meet again Saturday, February 4th, for game two of the series. That is also the final regular game, that is the final game of the regular season. That one on the road at Stillwater. Thomas Glenn here with Lakes Area Community Television. Thanks for tuning in. We always appreciate it. We are here broadcasting at Litch Idol Arena, located in the heart of the Forest Lake Sports Center. Forest Lake, well, they are perfect here at home thus far this season, 5-0. Rangers riding a two-game winning streak, and in those two games, yes, outscoring their opponents 9-2. Rangers with a record of 4-2 in the Suburban East Conference. Overall record 7-4-1. Stillwater 4-3 with an overall record of 6-7. The Rangers in the traditional home white, Stillwater in the red and black. Two line pass intercepted inside of the neutral zone. Nelson will hand that one off to Rugland, now fighting in the corners for possession. 0-0 is the score, 2 minutes into period number one. Picked up inside neutral play. Played off the boards, and that will make its way all the way down into Pony territory. Picked off by Rugland. That one played off the glass, sent into neutral play. Rangers forced to regroup. Stillwater on the move. That's disrupted by number 6, Sydney Rydell, for your Rangers. Tracked down by Valley. Forest Lake looking to clear. 14 minutes remaining here in this scoreless first period. Between the pipes for your Rangers is number 32, freshman goaltender Josie Botham. Thrown out front, in front of Botham, nobody home for Stillwater. That will allow the Rangers a little bit of time and space to move the puck. Dumped back into the Rangers zone. Nelson forced to track it down. Currently tied up along the near side boards. Will pop free. Stillwater will be forced to regroup inside of the neutral zone. Dumped back into Ranger territory. Played behind Botham. Looked like she had it covered up, but nope. Back to the blue line. Stillwater trying to get a shot on net. Puck still just chilling out front. Cycled back around in the near side, picked up by, I believe, Valley. Both Peterson and Nolan putting in work down there in the corner. Peterson over to Valley. Valley with possession will dump it back into the corner. Most of the Ranger shift making a change. Valley tied up along the near side boards. Eventually popped loose. Mackenzie Ruglin. Valley with possession at center ice. Cobalt with the backhand, that's deflected. Stillwater on the move. Taken away by Ruglin, Forest Lake will dump and make a change. Icing waved off, Forest Lake forced to play the puck deep in Ranger territory. They are able to advance. Neihardt. It's one thing you gotta love about this Forest Lake Ranger hockey team, and it looks like we're gonna have our first penalty here tonight. It's like a hooking, maybe handed out to Stillwater. Forest Lake should be on the power play here. Wait for official confirmation. There's no doubt in my mind that Forest Lake is on the power play here for 2 minutes. Just trying to establish why. All I got out of that was hooking. Rangers on the power play here for 2 minutes. As a two-minute minor for hooking has been served to Stillwater. And that would be number 21, Lexi Ligday. Here come the maroon and gold. Nolan, tough angled shot. That banks off of the side of the net. Forest Lake will maintain possession at center ice. Carried in by Gallinets. Her shot is deflected wide right. Peterson out front for Forest Lake. Got a stick on it. And heavily contested in the process. That will allow the goaltender for Stillwater to cover that up, resulting in a faceoff inside the Ponies. Faceoff won by the Rangers, back to the blue line. Shot taken from the high slot area. That is blocked well before it had a chance to reach the net. One-time opportunity out front for Valley. And although it looked like it might sail over the head of the goaltender and end up in the back of the net, instead, it ends up on top of the net. Another face-off here inside the Stillwater zone. Forest Lake on the power play. Shot on net, saved by the goaltender. Rebound via backhand, and that goes off the side of the net. Ruglin with a shot, and that is blocked. That will allow Stillwater to clear it. Now just 24 seconds remaining here in Ranger power play number one. Possession turned over to the Ponies and they will clear it. That pass there from Colbo is deflected back into the Ranger zone. Valley with possession. Two line pass. Thrown out front. to Ruglin, unable to get a stick on it. Again, Forest Lake throwing the puck out front. Nobody home for the Rangers. Stillwater with possession now out of the neutral zone. In Ranger territory, back to full strength. Saved by Botham. Botham struggling down there. Finally, we have a whistle. Technically, the officials are not supposed to blow the whistle unless they lose sight, or if one of the players is hurt, or there's a problem with equipment. But we'll have a face-off inside the Forest Lake zone. 8:30 remaining here in period number one. A nice grab there by Josie Botham, and we will do this again. 4 seconds removed. Forest Lake with 6 shots on net. Stillwater with 3-4. Another save there by Botham. Outstanding goalie. It's almost unimaginable to think that she is a freshman and just playing at a high level of hockey, and she's going to be around for 3 more years. So the kid has got quite a hockey career ahead of her. Forest Lake with an opportunity out front. Complete chaos has erupted in front of the Stillwater goaltender. Forest Lake unable to get a stick on it and somehow find the back of the net. We will have a face-off in the Stillwater zone. It doesn't look like any penalties will be handed out here. Nolan to take the draw for Forest Lake, won by Stillwater. Carried around to the far side. Nice stick work by Forest Lake. Peterson able to hold the zone. Definitely one of the more physical players for this Ranger team. Number 20, Courtney Peterson, not afraid to get physical. Looks like we are going to have another penalty being assessed here. Who is it against? Number 14 for Stillwater. That is junior Lauren Gella will serve a 2-minute minor. Forest Lake right back on the power play. Opportunity number 2. Oh, for one thus far. Let's see if they can get it turned around with this one. Possession or faceoff won by Stillwater. Unable to clear. Forest Lake will utilize the blue line. Excuse me. Tough angled shot. That's off of the side of the net. And that will allow Stillwater the time to clear. 1:30 remaining here in the second. Ranger power play. 7 minutes remaining in period number one. That one banked off of the near side boards. Back into Stillwater territory. Valley to Nolan. Shot on net. Rebound given up. Looks like back to the blue line. That shot is blocked. And will lead in a breakaway. Almost a total legit 2-on-1. Excellent clutch save by your goaltender, Josie Botham. Carried in by Ruglin. Nolan gets tripped up. Otherwise, that was the perfect give-and-go setup. Stillwater will try to clear, sending it near side, and that is held in by Gullinetz, but eventually Stillwater will clear. Face off inside the Force Lake zone, 5:50 remaining here in period number one. You're watching Tuesday Night Ranger Hockey here on Lakes Area Community Television. Stillwater unable to hold. Off to the race as we go. Force Lake forced. Nope, too late. Offsides is the call. We'll have a face-off just outside Stillwater zone. Force Lake looking to keep their perfect record here on home ice. They are 5-0. Now here at Lichheidel Arena. Played by goaltender Both, and Ponies now back to full strength. The Rangers with 8 shots on net at this point. Stillwater with 5. That one sent off of the far side boards. Rangers looking to make a rush here. 3-on-2 in the making, and that's thrown out front. Nobody home. Played along the near side boards. Both Remington and Valley and Ruglin down there putting in work in the corner. Nice job by Valley to step up, able to hold the zone for her Rangers. Popped loose out front to Colbo. That shot looked like it was going to find its way into the back of the net. Somehow, some way, goaltender for Stillwater able to come up with the save there. Ponies will clear. Rangers forced to regroup inside of the neutral zone. Instead, it's turned over, and here come the Ponies. Sent into the far side corner, played by Valley. Tied up along the high slot area. Stillwater making an odd man rush. 3 minutes, 30 seconds left to go here in period number one. Still a scoreless contest. There's an opportunity for Stillwater. Too bad for them. Bothan, no problem. Face off inside the Force Lake zone. Game number 13 on the 25 game schedule. Tuesday, January 3rd. First game for Force Lake Rangers in the new year. Let's see if they can bring it in. Anyway. Trouble out front. Botham back up to her feet. That shot will miss wide left. Stillwater will hold. Briefly. Rangers with a 2-on-2. That will be dumped in, but it doesn't matter. Force Lake offsides. We'll have a face-off just outside the Stillwater zone. Stillwater 4-3 while on the road this season, coming off of a 6-3 non-conference win on the road at Prior Lake that ended their four-game losing streak. Played by Peterson along the near side boards, has help from Rydell. Pass missed by Stillwater. They will recover. And now threaten with a two-on-two of their own. shooter for Stillwater, plenty of opportunities. Decided to take the shot, nothing wrong with that. But that is covered up by Bothan, resulting in a faceoff inside the Forest Lake zone with 2:19 remaining here in period number one. Ruglin with possession. Has help with her. Trying to create opportunities. Shot on net, and that is deflected. Unfortunately, Stillwater able to get a stick on it, and quickly as they clear it back into Ranger territory. Now under 2 minutes left to go here in the first. Carried in by number 22 for the Ponies. Yeah, I'm not even going to try and pronounce that name. What a pass to Slagle. Clutch save by the Stillwater goaltender. Nolan with possession. She gets taken down. Isn't that considered a check? That's what I'm talking about. Rangers back on the power play. Opportunity number three now in progress. Forest Lake with possession inside the Stillwater zone. That could have been an easy trip there. That will go unchecked. Stillwater able to clear. Bothan will come out of the net to play the puck. Now officially under 1 minute remaining here in the first. Let's see if the Rangers can get on the board before they head to the locker room. Drop pass to Slagle. Back to Gullinets, and that shot is deflected over the head of the Stillwater goaltender. Rangers will maintain possession. Shot from Nolan deflected. Gullinets with the shot, and that will miss wide left. Stillwater able to clear it. Now 10 seconds, 9:08:07. This should do it here for period number one. I don't think Forest Lake will have enough time for one last rush. And they do not. That will do it for the first scoreless game after one. Do not go anywhere. We have plenty more hockey yet to come here on Lakes Area Community Television.
Morning, Gary. We are GetSchooled.com. You want a college education, don't you?
You know you do.
Yeah, but I don't know where to start. That's why we're here. We're free, handsome.
I think we're breathtaking.
And here to guide you through every step of the way, starting with attendance. Gary, financial aid forms.
Biology homework, G. I got this.
Is that Brand? Colleges love extracurricular activities.
Chess really isn't my thing.
I got this. Doesn't matter. Go ahead. Picking a college, man. You and us. We go together like tacos and Tuesday.
And I love tacos.
Welcome back to Lakes Area Community Television, bringing you Ranger hockey here on this Tuesday, January 3rd. After one period of play, we are still scoreless here at Litchfield Arena. Forest Lake currently serving out the remaining 46 seconds. My bad. Stillwater is killing out the remaining 47 seconds of the leftover power play from period number one. Wow, did I screw that up? Forest Lake is on the power play. Stillwater is on the penalty kill. Now that we have that squared away. Ponies will clear. Played off of the near side wall by Valley. A little bit of miscommunication there. No harm, no foul. Forest Lake will carry it into Stillwater territory with 1 minute removed here from period number two. Rangers with 10 shots on net. The Ponies with 8. And that clears, since they are no longer on the PK. That's going to bring it back. That's icing. 15:41 left to go here in period number two. Rangers looking to extend their home record to 6-0. Faceoff won by Nolan. Play picked up behind the Stillwater goaltender. This game has like a 2-1 feel to it. I don't know what it is, but a nice setup by Forest Lake. Unfortunately, the puck ends up in the goaltender's glove instead of the back of the net. But we'll get there. Faceoff inside the Stillwater zone. Faceoff won by Forest Lake. The possession is immediately picked up by the opposition. Two-line pass broken up by Maddie Nolan, sent right back into the Stillwater zone. Parent with possession for Forest Lake. Stillwater inside of the neutral zone off of the near side boards. That's dumped in to Ranger territory, picked up by number 21, Aaron Slagle, one of the four seniors on this Forest Lake hockey team. There is a trip on Forest Lake, intentional or not. Looks as though Forest Lake will get nailed for a 2 minute minor here. I believe. Nope, just simply an offsides. Even better. Face off right outside of the Forest Lake zone, won by Stillwater. And they will regroup inside of the neutral zone before dumping it in to Ranger territory, picked up by Nelson. Sent around far side. Off of the stick of Remington, now dumped into the Pony zone. Pony zone. Just sounds funny. The Pony zone. Oh, wow. That was a clear and well-established check, which is not allowed. But I guess if you're wearing red, it's permitted. Kick save by Boffin. I mean, that was a clear-cut check. No penalty. Dumped back into the Forest Lake zone. 0-0 the score here at Lichheidel Arena, which is, as you know, located in the heart of the Forest Lake Sports Center. Kobo with possession. Forest Slate back on the attack. Just under 13 minutes now as that one, I believe, is covered up by the Stillwater goaltender. Either way, the officials have lost sight of the puck, and that is reason enough for them to blow the whistle. Faceoff inside the Stillwater zone with 12:42 left to go. Held in by Peterson. Turned over at center ice. Rangers now with possession. Looks like we may have another offsides here. Bringing the faceoff just outside of the Stillwater zone. Ruglin to take the draw for Forest Lake. Faceoff won by Forest Lake. And they will regroup inside of the neutral zone. That's dumped in, but that's coming back. Icing on Forest Lake. Pretty good turnout here at the Chidal Arena tonight. This community is pretty jacked up about this Forest Lake Ranger hockey team. Hoping they can make another appearance in the state tourney this year. Actually, I think Forest Lake set an attendance record down at XL Energy Center last year to watch Forest Lake participate in the state tournament. It's on the rush for Forest Lake. Send it back to the blue line. That's dumped back in by number 21, Aaron Slagle. Nice setup back to the blue line to Nelson. Now tied up along the near side boards. That's sent around opposite side. Remington with the touch. It's out front, available for Nelson. Gets a shot on net, and you've got to credit the goaltender for Stillwater with an excellent save there. Another faceoff coming inside the Stillwater zone. Just over 11 minutes up there on the scoreboard here at the Forest Lake Sports Center. Faceoff won by the Ponies. Played off in the near side boards. Unable to clear. That's number 11, Elizabeth Valley, for your Rangers. Stillwater back in the offensive zone. Remington with possession. Possession is picked up by Stillwater as they will dump it back in to the Rangers on that cycle back by Valley. Rydell able to get a stick on it, not enough to break it up. Shot on net, misses wide right. I believe that sentence was a contradiction. If it was a shot on net, it wouldn't be missing. Back to the blue line. They go tape to tape. Plenty of traffic out in front of the Forest Lake goaltender. Again, Stillwater from the blue line. Shot taken. Botham is down. Where is the puck? Picked up. Rangers on the move. Icing waved off as Remington had to step over the defender. He's now at center ice. We'll dump it into the Ranger zone. Oof. Okay, so yes, it looks like that hurt, but I don't see where you could assess a penalty for that. Okay, so what's the call going to be? Forest Lake has indeed been assessed a 2-minute minor. Waiting for confirmation here to find out what for. It sounds like checking is the call. Stillwater on the power play here for the next minute and 38 seconds. Being on the power play, that was a terrible time to make a change, by the way. Excellent save by Botham. Excuse me. Still trying to get rid of this chest cold. I won't go into too much detail. But, certainly has been a pain in the you-know-what. Nolan with possession for Forest Lake will send it around far side in an attempt to clear. And they have done so. 1 minute remaining in the Stillwater power play. As I was about to say, the power play for the opposition this season against Forest Lake has been a challenge, to say the least. Forest Lake almost thrives shorthanded. I don't know how many shorthanded goals they have thus far, but they certainly excel when they are down a skater. Do it for the Ponies power play. We're going to be 4-on-4 here for 40 seconds. Number 16 for Stillwater, Grace Howe, serving a 2-minute minor for holding. 2-minute minor for holding, and number 16, Grace Howe. Rangers with possession, number 11, Elizabeth Valley. Shot from Neihardt misses, but not by much. Rangers maintain possession inside Stillwater's zone. Played off of the boards by Valley. Like a little give and go, and that was intercepted by Stillwater, giving them the time to clear. That pass stolen at center ice. Number 20, Courtney Peterson with possession. Plays it off of the boards up to number 9, Maddie Nolan. Puck still sitting there, and it looks like we're going to have another penalty here. Like we'll be assessed a 2-minute minor. Enter 4-on-4 hockey here momentarily before Stillwater. We'll see a little bit of time on the power play. Except we got number 9, Maddie Nolan, for tripping. Stillwater with an opportunity here. Clutch save by Both, and Puck will remain in Forest Lake territory as they scramble along the near side boards for possession. Thrown out front, broken up by Peterson. Forest Lake with a potential 2-on-2. Peterson has Remington with her. And now it is a lot of red and black. Slagle, send it back into Coney territory. 5.5 left to go here in period number two. That's icing on Stillwater. Face off inside the Pony Zone. 41 seconds of power play time here for Stillwater. That was a quick whistle. Rangers with 13 shots on net. Stillwater with 11. Quick shot taken by Forest Lake. Unable to hold the zone. Stillwater with numbers around one defender. Bothan, another clutch save for her Rangers as Kobo will not so much dump it, but that's a shot on net. Stillwater goaltender. 18 seconds remaining here in the Stillwater power play. 4:52 remaining in the second. Tied up along the near side boards in the visitor zone. Still a scoreless game here at Litchfield Arena. Turnover in the offensive zone. Forest Lake forced to regroup inside of their own zone. Saved by Boffin. Stillwater will maintain possession. Thrown out front. Back in the near side corner. Played off of the boards by Nolan. Sent back in by number 6 for Stillwater, that is Gina Jablonski. Face off inside the Forest Lake zone. Picked up by Gallinets behind the Forest Lake net. Oh, imagine that. They're not going to call a tripping on Stillwater. I have seen at least 3 or 4 blatant calls that have gone unchecked by this officiating crew. Shot taken from the blue line by number 21, Lexi Legday of Stillwater. Legday, a freshman for Stillwater. Eight seniors on this Stillwater hockey club. Forest Lake with just 4. There's an elbow that goes unchecked. Mm-hmm. Forest Lake needs to clear as of now. They do and are threatening. Not much on that backhand opportunity as defender clearly got a stick on it in the process. 2:43 left to go here in this scoreless second period. Thrown out front for Forest Lake, one-timer, beautiful. Clutch save by the goaltender for Stillwater. Three on two in development, and I wonder why she shot the puck then. Still had plenty of ice to move. Picked up by Slagle, Forest Lake will advance the puck into Pony territory. Rangers making a change. Can't really agree with the timing there, but Botham advised to play the puck as there was nobody from Stillwater around. Pony's making the change. In the zone of Stillwater, Forest Lake with possession. Number 11, Elizabeth Valley. I believe that's Remington down there on the far side corner, now with possession. Thrown out front, but just too many bodies to make a clean pass. Valley will take it in. Thrown out front, and again, just complete chaos in front of that Stillwater net. That will result in another faceoff inside the Stillwater zone. Buck Unai left to go here in period number two. You are watching Tuesday Night Ranger Hockey here on Lakes Area Community Television. Game number 13. 25. More than halfway through the season already. That is crazy. Both teams scrambling for possession inside the Rangers zone. There's a shot on net. It's deflected, and that was just enough to change course and find the back of the net. Stillwater on the board with a one goal lead. Certainly cannot hold Bothan responsible for that. She did everything she could. Made the initial save. The puck was deflected once or twice, therefore changing directions on her. And at that point, there's just nothing you can do. See if Forest Lake can respond before heading into the locker room. Just 30 seconds remaining here in the second period. Forest Lake trailing by one. Wow, Forest Lake just got away with one. They did. The officials missing a pretty clear-cut slashing call. Not like they haven't missed plenty of theirs. All is good. All is well. And with that buzzer, that will do it for period number two. After two in the books, Stillwater with a one-goal lead. Don't go anywhere. We have another period of hockey yet to come here on Lakes Area Community Television. After two, Forest Lake 0, Stillwater 1.
ballerina.
Sometimes all it takes to be a dad is remembering how to be a kid again. Take time to be a dad today.
As an 18-year-old, I let my mistakes kind of take over my life. I was 0.5 credits away from completing high school, and I didn't do it. When I found out that I was pregnant, I know that I had to do something for myself if I wanted to make her a better person and provide a better life for her. My family never stopped pushing for me to be better because they knew what I could become and who I could become as a person. Surprise! My support team is amazing. The educational director here, my sister, and even my 7-year-old daughter has just been more than the support that I could ask for.
And to see you makes me proud.
I've been given an opportunity, and I'm just thankful for it.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
Congratulations on starting the journey to finish your diploma. While you may have heard people refer to their diploma by different names, such as GED, the High School Equivalency Diploma is basically a certification that says you finished your high school education.
Welcome back to Litchfield Arena and Lakes Area Community Television for period number 3 here on this Tuesday, January 3rd, 2017. After 2 periods of play in the books, Stillwater with a 1-goal lead to start out period number 3. Forest Lake 5-0 while on home ice. So let's see if they can get it turned around here in period number 3 and take this game back to extend their perfect record on home ice this season. There it is. Open net, goaltender out of place. Forest Lake unfortunately unable to corral the puck and get it in there. And I've got a hair in my mouth. Interesting. Picked up by Stillwater in the pony zone. They will clear it. Icing waved off. Forest Lake forced to play it. 1 minute now officially removed from period number 3. Rangers sit with 20 shots on net. The visitors with 17. Remington for Forest Lake will carry it into the Stillwater zone where she has abruptly met a couple of Stillwater defenders, and they are waiting to break that play up. It's sent now into Ranger territory, played by Peterson, sent around far side. Forest Lake looking to carry it out. They do, now in Stillwater territory. Neihart tied up along the boards. That did not take long. Looks like we're going to have our first penalty here in period number 3. This game certainly has been filled with them. This one will be assessed to number 10, Carly Neihart, 2-minute minor for something. Rangers back on the PK. Sounded like a holding call. Again, this Forest Lake Ranger hockey team just as dangerous shorthanded as they are on the power play. So Stillwater with numbers back on the attack. Looking for opportunities out front, nothing available. Back to the blue line. Bothan, a huge save, back up on her feet. Stillwater still threatening here with 14:24 remaining in regulation. Forest Lake will clear. Stillwater forced to regroup inside of the neutral zone. Possession loss picked up by number 27 for Forest Lake. That is Ashley Mills. Short-handed opportunity in the works for Forest Lake. Ashley Mills getting ready to unload that shot. It was abruptly poke-checked off of her stick. Short-handed opportunity voided. Nice drag by Nolan. Another one. Breaks my heart. It was just the perfect rush around two defenders. Unable to capitalize, but man, what an effort. Forest Lake back to full strength, just under 13 minutes remaining here at Lidscheidel Arena. The maroon and gold. Turned over inside of the neutral zone. Definitely one of the more speedier skaters for your Ranger hockey team, number 11. Elizabeth Valley, not like this team is in short supply of speed. This is one quick Ranger hockey team. Valley with possession inside of her own zone, now under 12 minutes left to go here in period number three. Pass to Parent behind the target, allowing Stillwater a turnover. Forest Lake now with possession inside of the neutral zone. One timer. Looked like it. She decided to take the shot instead. And now the goaltender has just found out where the puck went. Face-off won by the Ponies, I guess. Either that or it's a shot on net for Forest Lake. Either way, covered up by the Stillwater goaltender. 4 seconds removed, and we'll try the same thing. Neihardt just booted out of the face-off circle. That one off of the post. Remington with possession, that's cycled back. Held in by Peterson along the near side boards. Stillwater with numbers on the attack, there's a kick save by Bothan. Is that not a check? Give me a break. Dumped into the Forest Lake zone. Wow. I'm sorry, but that is shady officiating. Rangers with numbers inside the Stillwater zone, trailing by one. Prime opportunity for Forest Lake. Looks like they just ran out of real estate. Another save by Both, and Stillwater now with more shots on net than Forest Lake. Shot taken from the blue line, dangerous, a lot of traffic in front of Both, and still able to make the save. Stillwater able to hold the zone. Rangers need to get on the board here quickly. 9:36 remaining here in period number three. Played off of the far side boards. Forest Lake on the move. That pass intercepted. Stillwater now threatening. The arm goes up. We're going to have a penalty being assessed to. Yep, you guessed it, Forest Lake. Will be served up another 2 minute minor for who knows. Maddie Nolan will serve a 2 minute minor for just being on the ice. Forest Lake able to clear it. That should take a few seconds off of the PK. Stillwater on the power play with a one goal lead here in period number three. Back on the attack. That one timer broken up by Slagle. Able to get a stick on it. Carried up the near side. Played off of the boards. That one will make its way down into Pony territory. Stillwater back on the rush. 103 remaining in power play number 150 for the visitors. That's a power play goal for the Stillwater Ponies. Stillwater will now take a two goal lead here in period number three. Thank you, officials. You have officially blown this game. Face-off won by the Rangers. Let's see if they can get back into this game. They're only trailing by two. Shot by Colbo is blocked. Held in by Peterson at the blue line. Parent able to get a stick on it. Valley will step up for Forest Lake. Parent will take her spot back at the blue line. That one off of the glass should be an icing. Yes, it is. Faceoff will come back into the Stillwater zone. 7:27 left. Rangers need to get back to work. 5-0 here on home ice. Need at least three to make it six. Nolan with possession for Forest Lake. Number 21, Aaron Slagle. Remington tries to carry it out front. That play is broken up. Puck sent back into the corner. Look looking to hold it in along the far side, unable to. Forest Lake forced to regroup inside of the neutral zone. Eisen waved off. Stillwater now forced to play. Gullinets to Nelson. Nelson will dump it into the pony zone. That one will come back. That's icing on the visitors. 6:16 remaining here in regulation. Coming up next for your Rangers, they will be at Andover this Friday. That's January 6th. And then Forest Lake will be back home right here at the Forest Lake Sports Center Saturday, January 7th, to host White Bear Lake. That's back-to-back games for the Rangers Friday night and Saturday. Forced Lake unable to hold. They'll be forced to regroup again inside of the neutral zone. That's turned over. Stillwater with another rush. Initial save by Bothan. Attempts 2 through 4 are successful, and she will eventually get that covered up. Face off inside Forest Lake zone. 5:39 now left up there on the scoreboard here at Lichidal Arena. Rangers with 21 shots on net. Stillwater with 25. Cross-ice pass broken up by Remington. Forest Lake running out of time. Need to get on the board here quick. Shot by Neihardt. Ends up in the corner. Neihardt still on the attack for Forest Lake. Sends it near side. Like a decent rush here for the Rangers, threatening again inside the Stillwater zone. There's a shot by number 18, Colbrell. That's deflected into the corner, picked up by, I believe, Parent. Held in at the blue line, Nolan. Shot is blocked before it reached the net. Forest Lake still with possession inside the offensive zone. Stillwater able to clear it. Forest Lake forced to clear to avoid the offsides. Thrown out front, but nobody home for the Rangers. Forest Lake making a change. Nolan the only one out there on offense for Forest Lake. Here's an opportunity. Nolan gets taken down, and of course, no penalty called. Shorthanded rush by the Ponies is broken up. Out front, 14 unable to get a stick on it. Number 21, Aaron Slagle with possession. Squad trailing by 2, just over 3 minutes now remaining here in regulation. Let's go Rangers. Played by Nelson in the corner. Pass out front is stolen by Stillwater. Fortunately, catastrophe avoided. That puck sent out of play will have a faceoff inside the force leg zone. 2:45 left to go. Well, now we've got the timeout. Timeout taken on the ice by Coach Lou. Force Lake trying to draw up something here as they are running out of time here in period number three, down by 2 goals for visiting Stillwater Ponies. Stillwater currently 4-3, 6-7 overall. Your Rangers 4-2, 7-4-1 overall. More importantly, Force Lake has been perfect here on home ice thus far, 5-0. Rangers also in the midst of a 2-game winning streak, and in those 2 games, outscoring their opponents 9-2. Struggling to produce any offense here tonight. Let's see if they can pull it together for the last couple minutes here. And just in case you might have slipped your mind somehow, some way, you are watching Ranger hockey here on Lakes Area Community Television. This game is being held Tuesday, January 3rd, 2017. .245, trailing by 2. You have to start to wonder when and if Force Lake will pull Boffin in exchange for an extra set of legs out there on the ice. Faceoff won by Force Lake. Played off in the near side boards. Valley now with possession. Boy, is she quick. Looking for options. Throws it out front, but that is deflected well before it had a chance to reach its target. And yes, Bothan is out of the net. Force Lake with an extra skater here for the remaining couple minutes left in regulation. I know they can get at least one. I hope for 2 or 3, but in the attempts of Stillwater trying to grab an empty netter, they will pick up an icing call. Faceoff move down into the Stillwater zone. Force Lake with a 1:56, trailing by 2. Nolan wins a faceoff, shot by Colbo off of the butt end of the stick of the Stillwater goaltender. That could have easily led to a deflection into the back of the net. Parent to Colbo. That is covered up. We've got some pushing and shoving going on in front of the Stillwater net. Now the goaltender goes down. It must be open tryouts for the officials tonight. It has to be. Faceoff won by Nolan. Shot taken by Colbo. And we've got more bodies down in front of the Stillwater net yet again. Yeah, if you're going to hand out a penalty, they better be coincidentals. And that's if. Five on five hockey, or 5-on-6, since the Rangers have pulled their goaltender in a desperate attempt to get back on the board, or to get on the board here in the last couple minutes of period number three. I think they can do it. Parent back to Nelson. Colbo with the shot. That misses wide left. I think she was looking for a tip. Peterson with a quick shot on net. Puck still sitting out there somewhere. Stillwater able to clear it, but that's going to bring it right back. Icing under 1 minute now left in regulation. Stillwater 2, Forest Lake 0. Rangers with an extra skater. Boffin on the bench. Peterson will dump it back in. Out front for Forest Lake, and still no whistle. There it is. Forest Lake is on the board. Stillwater wanted a call, but no such luck. Rangers 1, Stillwater 2. Let's see if they can do this again. What a prime example of staying with it. You do not stop until that whistle is blown. Even then, it's debatable. Looks like we're going to have, I don't know. Waiting for confirmation there. I see one in the box for Forest Lake, two for Stillwater. Must be in coincidental fashion. I see five on the ice for Forest Lake, five on the ice. Nope. Four on the ice for Stillwater, five on the ice for Forest Lake. Boffin back in net, but she is ready to hit the bench. Let's see if Forest Lake can get this tied up. They got one. One more is needed. I have no idea what is going on here. I don't know why the faceoff has been moved to center ice. Stillwater will win the faceoff and immediately clear it. That's off of the glass. Forest Lake forced to regroup. Boffin back on the bench. Rangers with an extra skater or two. Let's see if they can pull this miracle off. Held in by Parent. Traffic in front of the Stillwater goaltender, currently tied up. Nolan throws it out front. Peterson with a shot. Oh, it was there. Just give us 15 more seconds. Come on. Damn it. That will do it here from Lichheidel Arena. Three in the books. Stillwater with the win. Final score, Stillwater 2, Forest Lake 1. This has been a production of Ranger Hockey in partnership with Lakes Area Community Television. Thanks for watching.